Hello, I'm Ty Mason from the DiabetesCouncil.com, researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. Today I'm going to answer the question, is Splenda good for diabetes? But before we get into that, make sure you download my free diabetes management book, which also includes a diabetes grocery shopping guide, foods to eat and avoid, by clicking the link below. For years, there has been a concentrated effort to provide sweetness without calories or carbs. Now, there are basically two types of these sugar substitutes. There are natural and artificial. Today, we're going to look at Splenda, or its more common name and generic name, sucralose. Splenda says it's made from sugar, so one would automatically think that Splenda is a natural sugar substitute. But one making that assumption would be very wrong. Splenda is an artificial sweetener that starts from sugar, but is chemically changed. If you were to research the safety aspects of Splenda or sucralose, you're going to find a wide array of opinions. Some say that Splenda is great. Others say it will cause cancer and kill you. Now, there are those that say Splenda will actually raise blood sugar. Some have said, once again, it will cause cancer. Others have espoused that the long-term use of Splenda could cause liver or kidney damage. Well, let's look at the science of it. A 2009 study by Lee Groat states that, quote, the collective evidence supports the conclusion that the ingredient, sucralose, is safe for use in food and that the sucralose mixture product, granulated Splenda, no-calorie sweetener, is also safe for its intended use. Now, Groat's looked at several studies on sucralose itself and supported all data that it was safe. This particular study was done to explore granulated Splenda to see if it was as safe as its counterpart. Her findings were that Splenda, in all forms, was safe for intended use. Groats then also studied in 2003 the effects of sucralose on the A1C levels of those with type 2 diabetes. She concluded that even when given much more than the recommended amount of sucralose, those patients saw no effect on glucose homeostasis in individuals with type 2 diabetes. So Splenda does not raise your blood sugar. A 2000 study by S.W. Mann looked at claims that sucralose caused cancer. His study of rats that were exposed to different levels of sucralose found that, quote, evaluation of the data obtained from the two phases of this study showed that sucralose was not a carcinogenic. Sucralose did not adversely affect the survival or clinical condition of any rats, and there were no toxicology significant findings, end quote. So, Splenda does not cause cancer. A 2000 study by McLean Baird concluded that, quote, based on these studies and the extensive animal safety database, there is no indication that adverse effects on human health would occur from frequent or long-term exposure to sucralose at the maximum anticipated levels of intake. So, Splenda does not cause liver or kidney damage. So, is Splenda safe for those with diabetes? Well, my answer is yes. Again, if you look at the internet and you research it, you're going to find everything from A to Z on this topic. But look at the science. I use sucralose exclusively as my sugar substitute. I don't necessarily use Splenda, but I do use sucralose-based products. And after researching the subject, sucralose, in my opinion, is the safest of the artificial sweeteners on the market. I hope this answered your question, is Splenda good or bad for diabetes? Don't forget to get your diabetes management book by clicking the link in the description box below. And as always, let me know if you have any other diabetes-related questions. Thanks for watching. I'm Ty Mason.